streaming, and now you'll see it come up live. So that's streaming. What does this say? Oh, no, we don't want to do that. Get my GarageBand set up. Turn my phones off. So I should just rename this GarageBand, or should I just open a new one?
Just open a new one. It's probably
I'll close that one out. Don't save. Open a Newsies. And this is episode 10, Josh.
Woo!
Episodio número 10.
Episode 10.
Número 10. Diez.
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 Diez. No, no, no. Do it.
No,
do
no,
some
no.
more.
No,
do
no,
it.
No, no, no.
Very slowly.
No, no, no.
What is that from, Josh?
I don't know.
I can't remember.
Oh, Family Guy.
No, from True Lies.
Oh.
Right? True Lies?
I don't know.
Where he's doing the recording or like, where he's, he's got Jamie Lee Curtis tied up.
No, no, no.
And they're doing the recording or whatever. No, 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 no. Do it. Do some more. Do it. Very slowly. I think that's what it is.
No, no, no.
All right.
Doggies outside. No, no.
Double click. And edit. And take away the reverb and the echo. Cool. All right. So that should be good. Now in here, should I have the volume all the way up recording?
It doesn't matter. That doesn't.
Because you can do that later, or is
that
it?
It doesn't affect anything.
It doesn't?
No.
Okay.
That only affects your outgoing.
Even the one up here, like even this one up here on that track, like it doesn't turn the volume on that track up.
Well, it'll take it up if you bring it up. Go ahead.
But like, see what I was thinking was like, if we're already processing it here and feeding it in, there's no need to like lower to process it there, right? So
well,
just have it all the way
post-production,
up.
Post-production, you may.
Okay.
You may want to do it post-production, not one, two.
Okay. Hey, boys and girls. All right, I guess it sounds good. We'll roll with it. All right, so that's good. Oh, boy, now I got the pressure. I'm feeling pressure now with this.
You got it.
I also
can't mess
but
it up.
I got to get that.
Once it's live, you can't mess it up.
I got to get that other thing going, too, though.
Wow, that's good.
That's pretty good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Java Antigua. Antigua.
I got to get this. Here's what I'm looking for.
Peter Pot.
What was the other thing that you had? Oh, the dad bods, okay.
Yeah, dad bod.
That's probably going to be the second half, isn't it?
Sure. First half will probably fill with food trucks and Cinco de Mayo.
Talk about, Cinco de Mayo.
Cinco de Mayo's on, well. We'll
Cinco
there.
De Mayo.
Yeah, we'll talk about some of that Cinco de Mayo stuff. Introducing Al is going to take damn 50 minutes anyways. explaining him and because we're going to have to do a good job explaining why we make so many Mexican jokes.
Yeah.
So our Mexican listeners won't hate us. All right. Are we ready to go live? Ready
sure.
to do this? Ready to rock and roll it?
Let's do it.
Do it.
Do it. Do it.
All right.
Ow. That's from
Booty Pop Pow.
Hey, she's in the studio or in the chat room.
Who's that?
That's Claudia.
Hello, Claude.
Yeah.
Hello, Claudies. How does it sound out there, Claudia?
Does it sound better? How does it sound? It's like a 15-second delay.
30 seconds
well,
later.
Well, 15 seconds to go out. Then she types it. I don't know what the delay is to come back.
We'll find out by the end of the show.
Yeah, by the end of the show, we'll know. All right. And then we're not doing any rule, anything he needs to know what we got going on.
What do you mean?
I don't know.
No. Well...
All good?
Whatever happens, happens.
All right.
Obviously no cursing.
Yeah, we try to keep it to a minimum.
I was able to clip out the one from last time, so I didn't have to put the E on there. But
so the audio is good, damn it.
Yeah. Five people already. Already.
I'm nervous. All right.
That's what happens when you sound good.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Uh-oh.
It's the pressure
Whoa.
On you. The
I don't
pressure.
Like where that's going.
Hey, home slice.
I don't like where that's going.
Let's go ahead and...
I
gotta get set up, man. The magic just doesn't happen,
all
right?
I can't be out all night long.
All right.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Alvaro El Engineero.
Here we go. Hit and record. Let's redo that. Sorry, Josh. You can cut it here. We'll be right back.
Bienvenidos al show de los dos hermanos con John y Josh.
Hola.
Hola. Hola. Boy, I already messed that up, eh?
It helps if you turn
yeah,
it on.
Yeah, I know.
You know.
Thank you.
Good job.
All right, God, Josh.
Totally botched that.
What a fun show we have ahead of us.
We do. What are we doing?
I don't know, but right now we should sound magical.
I know, because we have Alvaro Engineero, the magical sound engineer, who
Engineero, Engineero,
I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I hope so, because you're going to hear it a lot during this show.
It's the first.
I want a copy of this.
All right, it's the first piece of what do you call it? Production work. I've actually had to do.
I think so. If you want your own copy, you can get it on iTunes. Subscribe
Ooh,
to us.
Yeah.
At Dad Bro Show.
We'll have to come up with a longer
it's
version.
Free.
Yeah.
To
so
subscribe.
So Alvaro the Engineero, he is in fact a sound engineer, IT guy, sound engineer, kind of a jack of all trades, as long as it has to do with wires and plugs and things that connect to your ears.
Yeah. So if you're enjoying what you're hearing better than the previous shows, it's his doing. And
yeah.
If you don't like it, then it's his fault.
That's right.
Tweet Josh and John if you don't like it.
Yeah. We've been told we're only allowed to touch certain knobs now on our on our own board in our own studio.
Don't touch all those knobs.
Yeah. The engineer was now
only I touch that knob. You don't touch that knob right.
Yeah.
Only
that
I
knob's too sensitive
that
for you
knob.
To be touching.
So several good things about the show, obviously, other than the sound being much better. We're also going to kind of somewhat celebrate Cinco de Mayo in honor of our friend Alvaro the Engineero.
And Cinco de Mayo,
yeah. So tonight's drink of the show is kind of a... It's number one is a Cava Antigua. It's a tequila.
Sound engineer just dropping stuff all over the table.
It's an añejo tequila, which
añejo
I believe what does
means
that mean?
Old.
Means it's old, or does it mean? I thought it meant like a year.
It's aged.
Like years aged. Okay. So I'm being told from the sound room there that it means old, and so we're trying that out. This is coming directly from Mexico. Brought it back on my honeymoon, which has been a while. So it's also aged. I guess old is a good term for it, because it is old.
It's filled with tears now.
Yeah. I occasionally go back to this bottle to remember the good times, the honeymoon and the...
No more coupons.
Yeah. So we'll throw that up there for Alvaro, and cheers to everybody.
Cheers.
We'll let you know how that's going, and we'll be also just kind of side-saddling it with a little bit of Dos Equis.
This is a good tequila,
Lager Special.
It's a good tequila.
Oh.
Well.
Yeah, it's smooth. I like
so,
it.
So, is Cinco de Mayo a big holiday for you, Al?
It is not a big holiday.
It is not?
Not for my people.
What do you mean for your people?
It's a big holiday for white people.
Oh, it's not a traditional Mexican holiday?
No.
It's an excuse for us to drink again.
Well, see, the thing is,
it's an excuse for the Mexican restaurants to make lots of money.
it really is. It's really an Americanized holiday.
So you're saying that it would be like our Hallmark holiday?
Pretty much.
But what's the Hallmark in Mexico?
I have no clue. So, well, see, the real Day of Independence in Mexico goes on for a week.
I'd be down for that.
Well, then it's not a real Day of Independence.
Well,
then, is it?
It's. I mean, they call it El Grito de Guerra, which is a scream of freedom.
Oh.
Well, of war.
Okay.
That's what, and it's party from day one to day to the end of
to day cinco until you can't count anymore.
And it's actually, I think, in June and July. I'd have to check my calendar. I don't even know what today is.
Hmm. So I didn't know any of this. So is it a something that sort of took place when more?
It's the independence of Mexico, really,
right? But
from the Spanish.
But for as far as us caring about it. Was it more when the Mexican immigrants came here in large numbers? Or
I
is
have
it,
no idea what.
Or is it just we need another reason to drink and party? And
I think it's another reason to drink and party. Honestly.
So it's probably Corona created the
pretty
you
much
know, just like
that
putting a lime
seconds.
In it for no reason and
details.
Yeah, who cares? Who cares?
It's another day of getting another excuse. Yeah. It's another Saturday. You
put
know?
On a sombrero, look like an idiot.
Drink some tequila and beer.
We couldn't take Dia de los Muertos.
Day of the Dead?
Yeah, we couldn't take that because we already had Halloween.
That's probably a more serious holiday.
Actually,
is that a bigger holiday? That's a bigger holiday than...
That's another day to party.
Yeah.
They party for like a week for that.
Do you have any days that you don't party like that?
Look, man, when I was a kid and we'd go to Mexico, we would go there for Christmas. And I swear to you, every night was a party.
Yeah.
From the moment we got there to the moment we left. I don't think anybody worked, honestly.
You know, I think, when I was in, I went to Mexico for a week and I would say that nobody worked then either. And there was no holiday going on.
What time was it?
It was about, we go to the store about 1 or 2 o'clock and all of them are shut down. And
yeah, forget about it. That's the hottest point of the day.
Yeah.
And what drove me nuts is the activity directors or whatever, you know. We'll get a volleyball game going at 1 o'clock.
See, that's the problem. You went to with an activity director.
Yeah.
What does a white person know about?
Well, this wasn't a white person. These were...
Nice.
Yeah, these were locals, but it was a time thing. Like, oh, we're gonna do this in about a half an hour. So
I've learned. My youngest daughter goes to it's called Spanish for Fun. It's a Spanish immersion preschool, and so all the teachers are from native speaking Spanish countries, a mixture of them. So I've learned from the Hispanic culture that there is no time frame on events. Yeah. Parties, and I think it's something they've had to learn because it seems that they're constantly getting better at it because I think they get chewed out by the parents. But communication and sticking to a time are two things.
See, communication's not a problem.
Yeah,
sticking to a timeline's a problem.
Yeah,
let me ask you this: since it seems to be a cultural thing, why bother giving a time?
If
because white people need times.
Exactly.
No. Even without that, is it just, you know, show up at dark?
If you say 1 o'clock, it generally means 2:15-ish.
But why not just say 2:15 to
because 30? Then it'll be 4 o'clock.
It makes no sense.
Look, I swear to you, every Thanksgiving, every time back home with my parents, my family, every time we have Thanksgiving.
You guys have Thanksgiving there?
Yes, we actually celebrate Thanksgiving.
Americans?
We assimilate, okay?
Oh, okay, okay.
They say...
You know, we don't really celebrate Thanksgiving.
We're going to eat at 4.
That's a holiday that for you guys.
They say, we're going to celebrate at 4 o'clock. Here comes 8 o'clock coming around.
Yeah.
And we still haven't ate.
That would drive me nuts.
Hey, man.
I will give you some leeway. There's some leeway where I'm like, all right, well, a half hour,
Something always happens, but
4 hours?
Turkey doesn't cook or... You know,
it's 8 o'clock and they're still eating chips and salsa, Josh. Nothing's come out of the kitchen.
Every now and then, Grandma comes by. More chips.
More chips.
No. You go outside.
Wow.
So
there's a lot that we don't know about each other, Engineero. As far as you know, I had no idea. I thought Cinco de Mayo was a for real deal.
It's a for real deal in the United States, man. People tear streets up.
If it's not authentic to, you know, who the Mexican holiday that we're supposedly celebrating, then it just seems cheap.
I'm tearing everything up over here.
You are. You're knocking all kinds of stuff over.
What other holidays are we getting wrong?
But you can hear that in high quality sound, thanks to Engineero.
What other holidays are we getting wrong then?
Do we celebrate other Mexican holidays?
Well, no, that's about it.
What about St. Patrick's Day?
Oh, you want to know across the board?
Well, yeah.
No, white people like to celebrate Day of Dead. That's like, I'm like,
we don't.
Why?
What do you mean we like to? We haven't done it.
I've never been to a Day of the Dead.
I'm pretty sure you have.
No,
there's no way. You know,
I don't think
Julianne and Liberty in.
The only time I've ever seen celebrations of Day of the Dead is when I was in Mexico, and the kids were all dressed up, and they were like
with face painting,
kind of scary looking.
Yeah, they're kind of sketchy.
And going around like do they go around and get candy or no?
Not candy. What they
but it's like kinda, they have bags. Or
it's
kind
of
like
weird
them.
To me because what they do is they go and they put like food at the graves and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So it's kind of creepy to me. They put candles, you know,
are those the glass candles that are always next to the tortillas in the grocery store?
Yes, sir.
Is that
exactly
what those are for?
Well, they're called veladoras, which means to keep on overnight.
Uh-huh.
I guess, you know, they're night watch.
That's why they're so big?
Pretty much. Some of those things run for months.
But they're not scented or anything?
No. No, it's just plain old wax and fire.
Oh. Well, not only is Engineero a fine sound engineer and all that, but he's also a dad.
Yeah.
So he he fits into the profile here.
How old's the little guy?
Two.
Ooh, the fun.
You know what? We're pretty fortunate that he's not. He's very strong-willed. I'll give him that. But he's quite the.
Have you hit the terrible twos yet?
No, not yet. I hope we just blow past that.
The thing they don't tell you is that terrible twos is a loosely based age.
Sometimes it's three.
3 years is when, like, my youngest right now, I would say terrible twos is more of a terrible three.
You know, I'd rather have it at two because he can't really talk. You know what I mean? And they won't talk back at that point. Three, four, you know.
Yeah, they get mouthy.
Yeah, you know. I'm just like, what do you say?
But isn't it cool though? Like you're at a point now where you guys are communicating.
Exactly.
There's no. It's not a. You're figuring out.
Yeah. What they want.
What they want.
As soon as I come for work, outside play.
Yeah.
Outside.
Yeah. See when that. That's nice when he can tell you what he wants.
Yeah.
Or when something hurts, that's like the best part.
Yeah.
Because either you know you'll start rubbing and it's like you get.
Yeah.
You get what's wrong.
Although there comes a point where it does get irritating when it's. You know, what's wrong? You need more details than just this doesn't feel good or like this hurts. Like, well, what kind of hurt is it? Does it hurt like this or like that? Hurt. Well, what kind of hurt is it? Is it this hurt or is it that hurt? Hurt. All right, you know what? Forget it. Forget it. You just sit there and hurt then. And,
Yeah.
And so you...
Well, and it's helpful when, especially when the kids get sick, like if they're going to throw up or whatever. Like going from when the kids were young and there was no warning at all. You're just driving down the road and all of a sudden your kid's throwing up everywhere.
Yeah.
To now, like,
hey,
you know,
I'm going to throw up.
Like, oh, my stomach doesn't feel well. It doesn't feel well. I'm going to, you know, like generally they don't just say that anytime.
Yeah.
And our youngest one the other day, she did throw up and she was like, oh, I think I'm going to throw up. And she gave us clearly like a 5-minute warning. I just didn't take her seriously and wasn't really thinking clearly.
So now, being prepared. Are you the one that cleans up?
I was riding in the back seat at the time, so unfortunately, I was the one that had to.
See, you have that advantage.
Until we got home, and then we usually teamwork it. One of us takes the kid, the other one breaks down the car.
See, Katie doesn't. By the way, that's my wife. Shout out. You like how I plugged that in? she does not do throw up.
Yeah.
I don't know why. I mean, it doesn't bother me. Yeah. I'll clean it up.
It's.
I'd rather deal with throw up than the child.
Yeah.
I mean,
see, mine throw up in the middle of the night.
Ooh.
So there's no warning. It's just all of a sudden there's crying and you go, oh, what's going on? You get up and you're like, oh, great. I just fell asleep and now I got to strip the sheets and take, you know, give them showers and make sure everything's
trail from the bathroom to the beds.
Yeah. Get out the wet dry vacuum and start sucking that up. Yeah,
they make these things called liners.
Yeah. Well, no, it's not just that.
Great things,
on the it hits the ground. And I have to put just tarp down the entire room. But you never. The thing is, we don't know when it's going to happen. It's not like they have a bad day. For some reason, the vomiting is the start of them not feeling good. So, 1 o'clock in the morning. And what bothers me the most is I don't know how their little illness or whatever knows. But it waits for the nights that I've stayed up too late anyway, and I'm really tired, and I gotta get up early in the morning.
Nice.
And that's when they decide today's the day. Blah. Enjoy that.
Nice.
And then what? So and then I can't go back to sleep in my own bed. So we'll sleep in bed with you and roll over and kick you and enjoy.
That's a very tired.
Enjoy
morning.
Your evening.
I've been fortunate. Our stays home. It's home. I mean, man. Daycare, way.
So he doesn't get it. He doesn't get involved in all the germs,
all
and
that
the
nice germs,
the bugs, and all that stuff.
It's been 2 years. He's only gotten sick twice.
Yeah,
as
far as I can remember.
But as he goes out more, you can't keep him locked in the house all the time.
And he's not. And then that's one of the things we've noticed that now that he gets out more, especially you know, do church on Sunday, and he's in the nursery.
Forget it. Yeah,
forget it.
That's where
it's like a breeding ground in those places.
Yeah.
It's like even though they clean everything, it doesn't matter.
No, because
they're gonna pick everything.
Yeah,
up.
They get each other's faces. Everything's picked up, and then they put stuff in their mouth, and it's just forget it. You can't. Yeah, there's no stopping it.
Now, did any of your kids have like any? I consider advice. We He used to, this is probably my fault, but we used to give him a baby blanket,
uh-huh.
and he wanted to carry everywhere and shove it in his mouth instead of pacifier.
Yeah.
Completely fine with me. But, you know, Katie's mom got fancy, and she started cutting, like, these little pieces, strips of just fabric.
So making his blanket stylish.
Yeah.
Go with his outfits.
No.
Your kid's a stylish kid, so he has to have something that...
That guy has, he's like... He's like a connoisseur of fleece now.
Oh,
he will not take any kind of fleece. I mean, we have like this like pattern stuff that we got from the ECU Pattern Co. Pirates.
Yeah.
Plug.
Is this what you're here for, Al?
Yeah, pretty
just
much.
Just to get plugs?
Hey, man. Free advertising.
There you go. Good. Good.
For who?
Yeah.
For who?
Hey, man. Get a hashtag. Yeah. You can tell I've done this... Couple of times.
Yeah.
You know.
Wait, now you're bragging. Oh, man, this is fantastic. Look at me, everybody. Look how good I am. See how good I hear, how good it sounds? That's all me.
That's right.
And pretty smooth, professional. That intro, good stuff.
Engineero. Engineero.
Nice.
Yeah.
I actually like this. I am real.
So
this
with your kid.
You know, I'm going to start testing stuff with this. I'm going to figure out a way to connect an iPhone to a mic line.
Yeah.
And use that as a test instead of going, test, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, check, 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 check.
Just play
audio
through it.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
I want a longer one for you, though. I want, if you have a theme song, I want it to go a minute.
Oh, yeah.
That way, have a minute one and then a short one. That way we have... You know, a nice long buffer.
Yeah.
Just stretch stuff out. Just to get lazy.
we're already. Hey, well, look, this is episode 10. Whoop, whoop.
Big
episode,
milestone.
Right? Big milestone for us. So we're already at episode 10 talking about how we can get lazy and make give you guys less content and drag this out longer.
Drag it out for an hour. You know, talk about engineering.
Yeah.
Mexico.
Well, I had a question because. In your household, you know, you're bilingual.
Yes.
And your wife is somewhat bilingual. Yeah. She does pretty good.
Wow.
So I'm wondering with your, you know.
Kinky.
In my house, we're not bilingual, but we're trying to raise our kids bilingual, which is very difficult. So what is your plan? Are you intending on raising your son bilingual or
absolutely.
Not?
It's very nice to know two languages, especially when, I mean, for me. My most difficult, my first language was Spanish, obviously.
Uh-huh.
I think.
Well, obviously.
Engineer over here.
I know, but I'm just saying, you say it obviously, like, it's not like you have this thick Mexican accent that, you know.
Well, see, that's the thing, is that people ask me, why don't you have an accent? I don't know. I honestly don't know. I think in Spanish. I do math in
you
Spanish.
Think in Spanish?
Really? Yeah.
Huh.
It's
does that freak you out, Josh? Kind of freaks me out a little bit.
It kind of does, yeah.
Like, I look at him like, what is he thinking?
Well, see, that's sometimes I get tongue-tied because certain words don't translate into English, and that's the hardest part for me growing up. But, like, for Eli, I'm more than 100% that his thought process is in English.
Yeah.
Because he's sometimes confused of when I'm talking. When Mama's gone, we speak Spanish.
Yeah.
That way, you know, it's a lot easier for me to instill Spanish on him that way.
Mm-hmm.
Because
he compartmentalizes it.
Exactly.
And he knows that with
like,
dad.
Yeah, you impose.
It's like riding a bike. You know, it's like one of those things where if you switch the handlebars to the opposite way, you don't know how to really ride the bike.
Right.
You have to relearn stuff. And I think, I mean, honestly, the learning process is there.
Yeah.
Spanish is a much harder language.
Yeah.
They're just...
What?
Oh, absolutely.
Everybody always says English is the hardest language.
Not really.
Yeah, that's what
when
I thought.
When you're
not
coming
really.
From Spanish.
Well, the thing is, yeah, well...
when you already know English, well, it's not...
No, but everyone's like, oh, English is the hardest language. It's like, no, because you look at Spanish and you have all the verb conjugations.
Well, there's six ways of saying stuff.
Right. But like it's I ran, you ran, he ran, she ran. Ran is the same the entire time. Whereas, you know, you've got... where are all the... Go for it. I was going to rattle them off, but I don't know.
Well, same in Spanish. Corrimos, corremos, vamos a correr. I mean, I can go on. It just depends on how you say it.
So
I can take the same four words and swap them out and make something completely different.
Yeah. It's totally confusing to me. So, English is the hardest language you could learn.
Yeah.
I don't know. German seems pretty hard. Russian seems hard.
Yeah. German sounds angry.
It does.
I think most like Vietnamese, Korean.
Yeah, Chinese would be tough.
Mandarin, Chinese. Like all that seems very, very difficult.
But
I don't know. We're getting off track with that. So you are going for the bilingual household,
yes.
Which I think is beneficial for the kids.
Yes, absolutely. My dad doesn't speak. Well, he speaks enough to get by.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it'd be very good for him now.
Because a lot of times, I'm sure it'll continue this way, but you actually can have like a job that pays more because you speak two languages or because you're bilingual. Whereas you know, and that's the only reason why.
Absolutely right, because you're able to do international work mm-hmm. versus just domestic work. There's a lot of Spanish speakers here in the United States, but there's a lot more jobs available when you can speak both languages.
Yeah,
if you want to live internationally, it's a perfect example. I went before Katie and I got married. I went into Europe. It was a lot easier to find somebody who spoke Spanish in Germany and in the Czech Republic than it was to find somebody who spoke English.
Yeah, you speak English and Spanish, you pretty much open up half the world to yourself.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, the entire Western Hemisphere,
yeah.
English and Spanish will cover you, except for Brazil and parts of Canada.
Are you talking about California?
Yeah.
Well, not only that, but some of the languages like Portuguese and stuff kind of cross over Spanish, so you can sort of make your way through it.
I tried to learn some Portuguese, and it was my high school Spanish that was throwing me off because it was so similar that I was messing up. By the way, Engineero, you've been told that the audio sounds good. So
sweet.
So far, the reports are well.
Who's Lady?
Lady Empire would be our mother.
Just trolling you guys.
So,
that's awesome.
Yeah, Lady Empire's our mother, and she said things were sounding good. And just so everybody knows, she talked to a Russian guy the other day, and it was cool.
Was he hot?
It doesn't matter. Yeah. I don't know.
You can when she wants you to go set up her sound now. So when you
and you guys can talk all about that.
Okay.
So,
All right. Well,
that's Al in a
nutshell,
in a sombrero,
Engineero.
Thanks.
Yeah.
I couldn't think of anything in a jumping bean shell.
Yeah.
this is gonna go on for all night.
It will.
It'll be. So that was Al. He's gonna stick around with us too. But,
Engineero.
You know.
Honestly, I really like this. I'm not gonna lie.
So this is being his new sound check intros.
I am going to totally play. You know what? I'm like making you guys' ringtone.
Oh, okay. That'll be all right with me. So you guys today also went, before here, you guys went down to a food truck rodeo.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we did.
How was that?
The local food truck rodeo downtown. They take a whole city street. I think it's like 11 blocks, maybe. And what they do is they line up the street with these food trucks. They shut it down. They block all the traffic. And
you put some pictures on the feeds, didn't you?
Yeah, on Instagram.
Yeah.
Josh, you want to plug that?
Yeah, you go to Instagram, and we are at Dad Bros Show, DadBrossHow. It's the same for Twitter and Facebook, and you can also see us at DadBrosShow.com, DadBrossHow.com.
Yeah, so I put a few pictures up there of what we were enjoying. It was... Al the Engineero came in to town a little bit early, and I thought as a treat we'd go down and try to grab some lunch. They've got over 50 trucks down there, and it's free admission. There's really nothing special to it. They've got places to sit down, and they run generators for all these things, so it's not like you have all those gas fumes and just ruining the experience. But what does ruin the experience is the 50,000 people that show up down there. So it's become so popular in this area that... they do an event like this, and it's just, I mean, there's literally everybody's down there, and every truck has a line.
See, when we first started doing this, only the really good trucks had the line.
Yeah.
So if you were standing in line, you knew what you were getting was going to be worth it. Whereas now it seems like, all the good stuff's taken. Let's go stand in line for something.
Yeah, like before we would put one person in line for the good truck, and then we would run around and grab like three or four other things, meet back with that person, and we'd all sit there and munch and wait to get to the good stuff. I mean, it's all good for the most part, but
I wish I had known about this menu they had on there. They had the highlighted.
Yeah,
the that probably explains some of the lines.
Well, we went willy-nilly. We just went right at the last minute. Had we been professionals about this, Al, we could have drawn a map. We could have downloaded and printed the map and sort of drew, like, connect the dots to what we wanted to try most.
Make sure you hit this, and that. Plus, you would have gotten the band to come in early.
Yeah, I thought about that. But it's been, like I said, it was kind of impromptu, so...
Food trucks, we did all right for what we did.
But.
Food trucks are getting big everywhere, and honestly, I love the idea because it allows these guys to do something specific that they do very well without having to worry about catering to everybody. Yeah. I think a lot of places go wrong with that. You know, even a brick and mortar store. If you go look at Five Guys. Five Guys does burgers, fries, and hot dogs.
Yeah,
and that's it. But they do it so well. But most places can't do that. And the food truck, I think, gives them a chance to be very... You know, this is a peanut butter and jelly food truck. And that's all we do is peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Yeah,
exactly.
And they're amazing.
Funny you say that, because John and I were talking about that. It's like, we kept seeing kids all over the place, but none of the food is, like, really kid-friendly.
Well, yeah, I was going to ask you how you did with the kids, because that was one of the reasons I didn't go to this, was because I can't stand standing in line waiting for food with the kids because they get so impatient and it's hot. And
the best strategy that I found, which is what we implemented today, was we left them at home with the wife.
Oh. Well, I didn't know that was an option.
Yeah, we left them at home with the wife, and so we could just shoot right down there, hit a couple of trucks, and then come back.
But we
were somewhat on a time schedule today.
Well, you're at a bit of an advantage where your wife's not as much of a foodie.
Yeah,
as
she kind of can take it or leave it.
Yeah.
She obviously enjoys it when it's convenient and we can do it. And it has to be fun as well as enjoyable. Like, the food has to be enjoyable. So when it's not fun, it doesn't matter how good the food is to her. Whereas, like, for me, I can be miserable, but then whenever I have the food, it's like, you know, I have my little mini vacation just for 2 seconds as I'm biting into this delicious, you know, Korean burrito thing that somebody's concocted.
Well, we had Vietnamese today, so.
Yeah, we had it was like a gluten-free Vietnamese truck or something.
You really were looking for short lines.
We did. That one there wasn't too bad.
It was pretty bad. Even that was one of the shortest lines. And I swear to you, I stood there, 45 minutes?
At least we still implied the technique where we had Al go in and wait in line, and I grabbed a jerk chicken on a ciabatta bread
that was
it had
really
like a
good.
Sliced pineapple on the bottom with coleslaw.
Good.
And it actually was a lot really good. That line was super short, and I don't know why.
It's probably they don't have the reputation yet because all these trucks get a reputation. Like Churba has such a reputation now
that was the last one we hit. It had the dumplings.
I posted a picture of that one.
But it almost seemed like they were changing the way they did it. They were taking orders. The order line was very short, but there was a huge crowd of people waiting for the food.
Last time we did a food truck rodeo, my wife went to get a grilled cheese sandwich from this place, and the line was short. And they take your order, and they don't tell you it's a 45-minute wait to get your grilled cheese
they
sandwich.
They told us it was 20-minute wait, but, I mean, still the way they did it, like, you got through really quick.
I mean, it's dim sum. I mean, how hard is it to...
They have steamers, and occasionally the steamer goes down. Because they were at an event that I was at, which, by the way, it seems to be the better option now, is to just track these guys down and go get them.
On their web pages and follow.
Yeah, because rather than going to a rodeo, sometimes the food farmers markets around here, they'll hang out around there. Hmm. But to find them there as opposed to at an event seems to be a better way to go now, because the crowd, it's so ridiculous with the crowd. It's not fun anymore. It's the fun that's been taken out.
That's the part. Yeah, today I was really bothered with is just the sheer number of people, and then like the kids that are being like.
What got to me is how the lines form. That makes absolutely.
There's no rhyme or reason to the line.
I mean,
being formed.
John said, "Well, why don't we just line up in a U so we can see who's first and who's last?"
I was saying if we just went like, because one of the lines kind of went in this J shape, and I was like, "Well, if we just added some more people, we'd be like a full circle." And then you could just be like, I don't know who's first. We'll just kind of, so it's like a circle that just constantly rotates around and people just kind of jump in wherever they want. I don't know.
And then John was saying there's like a band you can get for VIP.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like.
So they had like an early access. And what they did is, so around here, I guess the food truck rodeo is like a season thing. Mm-hmm. Obviously, when it's a little bit warmer outside, they want to do it so that people will come out to it. Nobody's gonna be out there if it's freezing cold and snow.
I don't know. I would be out there if it was.
I would, because I know there'd be less people.
I think honestly today was a fluke because it was a really, really.
It was
nice
a gorgeous
day
out.
Yeah. Yeah, but at the same time, the last time I did one, it was packed like this. I mean, people really are into the food truck thing now.
Yeah.
And
but
know,
so they had they had the VIP band. It was like $25, and that covers you for the whole season. And I think you get in get in an hour early to each event.
See, an hour, I don't know if an hour.
But I'm
is
like,
enough.
Well, how many trucks can you hit in an hour? Yeah, it depends on how many people. And there, and from you know truck number one all the way to truck number whatever 50, you're talking. I mean, there's almost 11 blocks.
Yeah,
I mean,
and
it's a good
are all the trucks ready to go at that point?
I don't know.
Some that's one thing about the
setup
food truck
wise,
people
some
is,
of them.
Is some of them are not as. I don't know what you'd say, but they
Johnny
don't,
on the spot.
They don't roll up ready.
No.
They kind of roll up and then, you know, oh, well, we need about this long for this to happen. That well, you guys should have showed up earlier.
Yeah, like they got to finish their chai lattes and they got to, you know, get all that.
There was a lot of hipsters there. I'm not going to lie.
It's a total hipster
thing. The hipster scene was unbelievable.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a total hipster thing, but
yeah.
Apparently hipsters think food's good now, so
I guess that's the new cool thing to do.
Like to
no eat. PBRs,
whatever.
Yeah.
Skateboards.
Yeah, no, they'll still go for that. I think. That's so irritating.
I do think what they are missing is maybe some live music down there, some live like a main stage or a couple of secondary
but it
stages.
Would take, you don't think it would take away from the food trucks?
I don't. No. I would hope that it would distract some people. Like some of the hipsters might would like a bug to a bug light. They want to go to the stage and you know.
Well, not only that, but it would at least make the waiting a little more tolerable.
Oh, yeah. Man. They did have music, but man, that stuff was blaring.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was great.
They had little... They had
nobody
little,
sees you shaking your head up.
I know.
They have these like little tiny speakers that are, like I guess they're like directional speakers. They kind of just
know,
they just sort of blast out high trebly music and like a Canon speaker where it just goes in a direction.
It was
And they're just playing this random mix of like off of somebody's iPod that just... it was all over the place. There was no... rhyme or reason to it.
Was there an official DJ that pushed the button on the iPod?
I don't know. Like, that would be cool too. Is like if you just had a stage where there's just a DJ and all they're doing is just playing music.
But I've
know.
Seen DJs now that all they do is they just set up the phone and then they hit play and it look and then they just sit around scrolling around like they're actually doing something.
Yeah. Well, it's like a guitar player when they do those really big over the top movements and then they get down real low on the neck and they pretend like it's super hard. It's the same thing.
Well, I saw a guy. I saw a video of a guy who was DJing a birthday party or something, and he's doing all this. He's doing all this crazy like scratching stuff and then whoever's filming it
it's not even connected
it's not plugged in anything he's just doing it for show
a Mexican guy doing
I think
it was hilarious
it was really good like oh no
yeah
but nobody it's called him out on it the guy just with the video
it's like all the new DJs today I mean these people go to like stadiums and stuff and pay like top dollar for like live music
yeah
you're just going there to go see a DJ hit play.
Basically,
I mean, seriously, $60.
I'm not into that.
I don't know.
I think that would kind of spice the place up a little bit. I know it might bring more people down, which would be a problem. So, I don't know if more food trucks would help. Could the food truck survive when there's not a rodeo? I don't. You know what I mean? Like, is it oversaturated?
I don't know if you can do more.
According to this list, there was 50 food trucks out there.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
But they also include everything
from
like
local pops.
They include
like
every one of those little ice cream stops. They include like the people who have like they sell boiled peanuts, like
coffee.
Yeah, coffee.
There was that one ice cream truck. I mean, that line was even longer than.
What was the name of it?
I forget what the name of it.
Yeah, it was down. It was right down by Chirba Chirba, and the line was longer than the Chirba Chirba line.
Because there's an ice cream place in near us that does really well.
Yeah, I know which one you're talking about. Yeah, I think they were down. Chirba was on. Well, I don't know. They were
it
down
doesn't
in,
really matter, I guess.
No, it doesn't. It's just
but I don't know, but you know, the line was ridiculous. It was like a block long.
Really?
I think it's the parlor. Or something
was it
like
yogurt?
That. The macaroni truck was closed up. I don't know if they sold out or they just couldn't keep up.
Yeah, that's
or
the thing too.
They weren't selling anything.
That's the thing too. Is that how much can these guys keep on hand? You would imagine they'd just be shutting down left and right.
Yeah, we were there towards the end of the thing, and they were really just still pumping out food. And
I mean, you figure out
dim sum did that truck?
They were shutting down.
When we ordered when you left and to go get the cupcakes.
Yeah,
that's when they stopped. They They closed.
So like basically they gave out the last ones and they were like,
yeah, but they were just filling orders.
So
at
wonder
that
they
point.
Take. I wonder if they take the orders and they know how many they have,
probably.
or do they just take them and then refund if they can't supply it?
No, I think they know.
Yeah,
they
must have.
Now here's the thing too, is that when you do these food truck rodeos, there are certain trucks that I know I like and I would want to go to.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I'll miss new stuff because
you want to hit your old.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're,
like if I don't hit the Urban Street Grill.
Yeah.
If I don't hit that truck, I'm not going to see them again because they're you know 2 hours away.
Yeah.
So you know it's like I got to get to that one and then oh that truck's really good. I know it's good.
Yeah.
So I'm passing all this stuff that I don't know and some of it's because you know you I fall in the same trap of going to like when in Las Vegas you know
yeah.
you have. Okay, I know these are good, and I know I want to go to them, but there's all these new places. So how do you balance that?
Yeah, you really can't.
What was funny to me is that they had, like, this food truck, and it was a taqueria, a Mexican truck.
Yeah, I know that
and,
much.
And
is that
I
what
mean,
taqueria is Mexican, or what does that mean?
It's a taco cooking. Truck.
It's just me.
Oh, taco. Okay.
Taco.
Yeah.
Taco.
Taqueria. That's what you get after you eat it.
It's a taco restaurant. That's
you get taco. You get taqueria after you eat the Mexican food.
I don't think that's what you get, but you know, it's a lot worse. Nothing but my people were there. It's like
lined
about,
up for it.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't see that.
I pointed it out. We walked right past it.
Yeah.
It was on that street. Where
so you know that truck's good. Then we should have went there.
Yeah.
Well, see, that's the thing. It's like I don't understand that. My culture, sometimes I don't understand. They won't go and taste something else. Taco truck, right to it.
Yeah.
Well,
seriously.
You got to figure, though, too, if you're in a place that is everything is new, you want something familiar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
sure.
You know, I mean, if I'm in another country, like every foreign country I've been to, I want to go to their McDonald's.
Yeah.
You know, one, to see what it's like, and two, yeah, I've had enough of this. I want something I know.
Yeah, I can see that.
Like, I go to see what they're pushing as their local feed because a lot of times at McDonald's there's like different.
Oh, yeah.
There's different stuff.
They have some
yeah,
better
like
stuff.
Is it Korea that has it?
They have
black
a
black bun. Like oh, it's like
I think it was Japan that had that.
Is
yeah,
it
Japan?
Japan
Japan had the like the tonkatsu chicken sandwich or
they
something.
They had a
like
fried
that.
Shrimp sandwich too.
Yeah,
and they had the Mega Mac, which you would figure
what's
a
Mega
Mac? A Mega Mac is a Big Mac, but with. Double the patties, double the cheese.
Wow!
So, and you would figure that would be an American meal, right off the bat.
Yeah,
we would have that, but nope. The little Japanese people,
yeah,
have it.
And I think in Australia they had hot dogs at their
the
McDonald's.
Japanese.
Yeah. Well, they're not all very big. However, I will say that they to watch them eat is something incredible.
Yeah.
We just, went.
What they do? Scarf it all.
They eat so fast and so much. We went. The family we stayed with. The dad, we all went to this udon bar, you know, and we got these giant bowls of udon soup, and the noodles are huge and everything, and the soup is hot, and we're all eating and trying to not burn our mouths and so we can enjoy everything else, and the dad just, and done.
Wow.
It's like, oh my, what?
What happened?
You eat like a half a basket of bread before that?
Yeah, I was like, no. Well, no wonder Kobayashi won the 4th of July hot dog eating contest. This is what these people do, is they just scarf down food.
That's awesome.
But I've heard that part of the reason that they do that is so that they can go right back to work. It's, you know, eat fast and then go back to work.
So money is the driver for eating?
And not so much money as it is, you don't want to be the one that holds everybody else up at work.
You're going to lose trying to explain this to him, to his culture.
Yeah, yeah.
So you want to eat fast so you can get back to work?
Hey, man.
You don't want to take siesta?
Wait.
My people aren't Walmart.
So is there a soccer
South
game
American,
on? Because if there's a soccer game on,
hey,
nobody's
man.
Working.
Yeah, we got to eat fast
World
to get
Cup,
to watch the soccer game.
World Cup, forget it. Everywhere
yeah.
you go.
Football.
Football.
I didn't see that. All the shops are closed, and they're all gathered around the TVs that are in the...
It's soccer's pretty important.
Well, to you
or
guys.
Football.
It's not so important here. So at the food truck, there was one truck that kind of grabbed my attention because, namely, it had 1,000 people lined up for it, and I've never seen it before. And so we bypassed the line just to see what the menu was. and this thing was dressed up and called the Bacon Response Unit.
Oh.
I think they're Master Bacon. I don't know. The way they had
Master Bacon?
The way they had it lettered
Master
up, it was difficult to understand what the actual name was.
Oh,
but they titled the truck clearly Bacon Response Unit. And it was like, they had like, remember the Scotch eggs we had at that Irish restaurant?
Yeah.
They had a take on that. That was like, but they dipped it in like a buffalo sauce. So it was like a buffalo something egg bomb is what they were calling it. And then they had a bunch of just different stuff with bacon. It was like bacon wrap, bacon sandwiches, bacon, like all kinds of stuff.
Hmm.
So I'll have to bring them up their menu or something online. We might have to track them down locally.
Yeah.
See what they do. But that one definitely got my attention.
And that's another one that had, they had a ridiculous line.
The line that was probably the biggest line we saw the whole time. So I don't know. It was because the one that's usually the dumpling truck that's usually super full. It was busy, but they had like 7-8 employees. Like, I mean, a lot of people working there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, they do
getting,
really well.
Yeah, they're getting really serious about it.
I think they have. I think they might have opened a brick and mortar actually. And that's the thing too is that again, you know, going to the rodeo, you're almost. You would use the same amount of time to track these guys down and go find them on a regular day at that point.
And as soon as they open a brick and mortar storefront, you're like, yeah, I've had that already. I don't need to go there.
Are they going to be that good, really?
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, I mean, honestly, it's a food truck. Why would you? It's like Chick-fil-A taking a truck down there.
Well, come on now. Let's not.
Well, now we had this discussion while we were sitting there eating our banh mi.
Mm-hmm.
About what if Chick-fil-A had a food truck? Because there are some food trucks out there that are like local restaurants who are trying to get in on the food truck game. What if like Chick-fil-A, what they did was they had a food truck and they parked it out there and they, I'm going to get really detailed, and they set it up and they opened the doors. Sorry, guys. But what they did was they took the food that they normally have, but they prepared it in different manners. And came up with different recipes.
See, they wouldn't. I don't think you could
like
do that.
Like Thai chili, you know, chicken nuggets.
It would be cool, but I don't think they would.
But you could only get these set up. Like you can only get these meals from the food trucks when you go. Like so, like it would be something they're using the same products and stuff. They're just you know using some of their R&D to figure. Like how we talked about Taco Bell comes up with stuff, but it's all just using the same thing.
Yeah.
Like similar to that. Like you're making salads that are I don't know. This is why I'm not on the R&D for Chick-fil-A, Josh.
I'm sure Chick-fil-A would do very well because the Chick-fil-A in town cleans house.
Yeah.
Like they always have a line. But let me ask you this. How do you think a Hot Pocket truck would do there?
Ooh.
When we went out to Boston for PAX, outside of the convention center was a Hot Pocket truck.
Hold on,
Hot Pockets.
Like frozen Hot Pocket?
Hot Pockets.
Hot Pocket brand?
Hot Pockets, yes.
Do they serve them as hot as you get them out of the microwave?
I think they have. I would imagine that they have like those toaster type things that they have at like, Subway, so that it's a crispy outside. So, because you know the difference between a microwave hot pocket and a baked hot pocket.
Yeah,
like a night and day difference.
Yeah.
So if you had a truck that just sold hot pockets,
that's what was the time to bake a hot pocket. Honestly,
see you know,
if you had one of those baking things that they have at Subway to toast the subs,
one of those fancy 15-second toasters.
What were you gonna say? Engineero, I'm sorry.
I don't know. I totally forgot.
Interrupting you. Pork belly features. Pork belly is you know, so good now.
I was going to ask so if they
bacon
pulled
wrap
them out
cheesecake?
Like radiation hot, where they're like...
Where the center is just molten.
Yeah, you know. I don't know if you guys were... You
honestly,
know, when you guys were kids.
When we were there, it was so cold, it would have been a welcome...
Best sticking in your pant pocket.
Yeah. Oh. When we were kids, we were very familiar with the Hot Pockets.
Yes.
Actually, we used
the
to
knockoff,
get
the Aussie.
Those weren't knockoffs. Those were better.
Were they better?
Aussie pot. Yeah.
Were they from Walmart?
They
or
were
something?
No. They're
from Sam's Club.
They're from Sam's Club, and it was like this cheesesteak inside of a pastry crust, like a
churrito, taquitos they sell at
it was
Sam's
like a,
Club.
No, it looked
meat
like
pie.
A hot pocket.
It was
like a big.
Yeah.
It was actually bigger than a hot pocket too, wasn't it?
It was an Australian meat pie, and apparently they were very expensive, or not very expensive, but they were pretty expensive, and. We would come home from school and probably have like four of them.
They were good.
So our dad's like, "Who ate all the damn Aussie pies?"
Well, the problem was
the infamous recliner.
I don't know. So they were good, but the problem was it took you like cooking three of them to figure out the amount of time it took to get them properly cooked, so the center wasn't too hot or it wasn't too frozen. So you cook two of them and you're eating one while you're like, "All right, why cook that one too long? This one's got to go in first." And then you have to make four of them. And then finally by the fourth one, it's like perfectly crispy on the outside. The inside is just melted, but not hot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you know how it is like when you're 12, 13 years old and you got a bottomless, you know, you can just eat as much as you want.
That's awesome.
And well, in my case, I got really fat, but still, like I could eat. There was no capacity there. And, you know, I get home from school and I'm hungry and there's these delicious Aussie pies. That,
yeah. Delicious squares of scrumptious.
Yeah. A case of 50 of them.
Yeah. But, well, here's the thing, too, is that at that time, if you remember, do you remember when like, Subway came out and that was good? And then Blimpy came out and was like, oh, this is better. This is better. You don't have to go that far into it. All right, but, you know, like then Blimpy came out and made Subway not look so good. And then Quiznos came and made that look. So everything is getting, you know, exponentially better, which makes the thing that was originally there that was good enough not seem so good.
That's
what Hot Pockets was. Hot Pockets were really good when they first came out because you had nothing else to compare it to. It was the first time you had a microwavable, sandwichy thing. You know, so
it tasted like you cooked it,
right?
Or you baked it,
yeah.
Tasted like a pot pie.
Hey, did you ever have one of those sandwich maker things where it's like do you remember that?
Yeah.
You put
the bread in there, and then you put the filling in. You put the bread on top, and you close it.
It's
up.
It's like a waffle press.
Yeah,
I know.
But
exactly.
You could make pies with it.
It's a cross between a waffle press and like a vacuum sealer.
Yes,
it's supposed to like seal the edges up and make little pockets.
We actually had
one,
and I burned myself with one of those. Never ever told my parents I burned myself. But yeah. I got myself good messing
with
one of
those. Turn Wonder Bread into pie.
The best part of those is, you know how they had that divider
uh-huh.
in between it? And when you close it down, and if you left it a little bit too long, it would get like really crispy on the edge. And as you ate towards the center, it was nice and gooey.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God, that was
yeah,
so good.
I ate a lot of stuff off of that, too.
Well, hey, we've never done, have we ever taken a Hot Pocket and deep fried it?
Ooh. No.
Ooh.
No, we haven't. That's a good idea.
That's your mind being blown right there.
Will we batter it first and then fry it?
We'd have to play with it. I don't know. We'd have to fry it first, try that. Well, because here's what I was thinking was with your Hot Pocket food truck, like what if you were making, you had your doughs and you were actually making fresh Hot Pockets, not in the truck, but you were doing it at your kitchen or whatever. You made your fresh Hot Pockets. So it's not like you're just heating up Hot Pockets and selling to people, but you're actually making... Like you can be like, oh, well, there's free range.
I like where you're going with this.
Free range chicken.
You know,
dad bro experiment.
And then I'm wondering though, like, what would you name the truck? Because you couldn't just say Hot Pocket truck.
Caliente pockets.
You know, it'd be fun. You know, it'd be nostalgic if you put like microwaves on the outside, so they can microwave their own.
What I would do is I would
offer
instead of having the window where like you serve the food from, I'd have a microwave mount on the side of the truck and the back of it's cut out.
Nice.
So when they're ready,
when
the food's ready, the microwave lights up, they push the button, the door opens, and they just reach in and grab it. But you just put it in from the back side.
All right, here's what we got to do. We got to get the turkey fryer out.
Yep.
We got to get the oil heated up.
Yep.
And we got to pick a whole bunch of stuff to batter and fry.
I was also thinking
there's a suggestion for a McDonald's fruit pie.
I could see that, but I was also thinking a Pop Tart.
Pop Tart?
Deep frying Pop Tart.
Cheeseburger? I could deep fry a cheeseburger.
Isn't it
the McDonald's fruit pie?
No, the cheeseburger's not deep fried.
It's
not
McDonald's.
A cheeseburger. The McDonald's fruit pie.
No, but
I think
if you
they
battered
fry
it, fry it.
But if you battered it with like a funnel cake batter or something and then fried it.
I would much rather have like a tempura batter, you know, light
with a
flaky,
crispy,
you know, where you know, the flavors don't really escape, but it takes on the flavor.
And it's
not
soggy and greasy.
It's very crispy.
I agree with you.
Yeah, but I think trying to deep fry a Hot Pocket could be something.
I'm up for that.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
I'm down.
But I'm thinking,
this is how good stuff is made. It's like those hot dog donuts we had the football game, football season where we take a hot dog and wrap it with bacon.
We stick it right in the donut?
Yep.
Mm.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I missed out on that one. Did that when I wasn't there.
You gotta warm the donut up, and then you take the hot dog, and you just
stick
it through it.
We took these football
donuts. Then you eat it from the backside?
We took these donuts and cut them in half. We did breakfast.
Yeah,
that's how it started.
Well, the Krispy Kreme for like during football season on game days, they make football donuts. So they're slightly longer, elongated, and allow you to slice them. So the Engineero also doubles as our grill man during football games. Tell him what you did with this thing.
Took that thing, cut it in half, put it on the griddle, and we
made it golden brown on the inside. You know how donuts normally, obviously, donut, doughy on the inside. Oh, yeah. We made it crispy.
Now, before you go any further, the Luther, the donut sandwich, that's donut how they burger. Do it, too. They cut it in half, and they crisp the inside of it. So
yeah, we made
you have to do it that way.
See, but here's the thing. Here's the kicker. It was bacon grease on the griddle.
Oh.
Yeah. Because, obviously, we had just cooked the hot dogs. Because we had a bunch of hot dogs and bacon left over for some reason. And then...
Wait, who knows?
Who knows, you know? John thought it was a good idea to grab a pack of hot dogs. We're like, okay, John.
And it was, wasn't it?
It was. It was. I'm not going to lie.
Doubt me not.
So, I mean, why let food go to waste?
You sound like you're getting emotional about it.
Oh, it's so good, dude. You have no idea. It's so wrong, but it's so right. I don't know how to describe it. It's salty, it's sweet, and it melts in your mouth.
And with that, I think we're...
I had intel. I figured out or got intel on what the engineer burned his hand on, what he was trying to make. He was in his little press machine.
Uh-huh.
He was trying to make empanadas.
Empanadas?
Empanadas. Nice. He was trying to take a grilled cheese press machine and make empanadas.
You know what? Funny you say that, because
it makes a great empanada machine. You're a banana. Oh, folks, stick around. A little more of this.
Engineero.
And, you know, what we do. So hang in there, folks. We'll talk to you in a minute. If we turn our mics half, like turn them halfway up, then maybe when they're more commercial, people can kind of just move it, listen, not super loud, see what's going on.
Kind of have an idea what's going to happen.
Yeah. Well, I tell you, the tequila's not getting drunk as much as something else, but it's not bad.
Has a little of appetite to it.
Yeah. I think it's mainly the glasses.
We're drinking shards of glass over here.
Now we can bring out the Mexican hat dance. How about that?
Sure. So, I just came up with an app idea.
Yeah. Hold on. when you were sending me text messages, I guess you were sending me some of the new emoticons, like the colored thumbs up or whatever. But because I wasn't upgraded to it yet, it would send the regular thumbs up and an alien head.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
So I was doing that to, I think it was to Claudia, and she was getting, like, she was getting on her watch. And she was, so I would send her, like, a colored thumbs up or something. Hey, you hear me? And, you should be hearing me now, right? Oh, because I'm soloed right here. You can hear me now.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. Why is this rock still? Okay. So I sent her a text like that with a colored thumbs up, and her phone came up with a thumb and an alien head. So apparently, if you want a black thumbs up, thumb and alien head's what you use to get it. Because I was wondering, like, why are you putting alien heads after everything you do? I could never get that. Yeah, right. Welcome to the show.
Yeah, mute yourself.
We're all unmuted now.
Now we're down to 3 viewers. Way to go. That was too
long of a
break.
Oh, God, guys. What's wrong?
Oh, your music.
Yeah, I wasn't ready for it yet.
No. Oh.
But I'm, when I get in there. He's over-engineering, oh.
Hey, man, I'm so used to being behind a board. It's not even funny. It's like, you guys would just do the show, and I'm the one.
Well, when we get more subscribers.
Hey, man.
Subscribe, people.
Subscribe.
Subscribe-o.
Instagram, follow. Yeah, Gabber Show.
Yeah, we.
Facebook, gonna. Twitter. I haven't seen much.
How about you can
guys?
We're not very good with Twitter.
No, Instagram is where it's at for, because I do a lot of the Instagramming. Josh has been getting good at it, and then I didn't have Twitter before, so I don't.
I'm kind of getting out of Twitter. I think Twitter's on its way out. You saw their earnings, didn't you?
Yeah.
And the big tank at the stock market and.
It's a very limited market on Twitter.
You know, we can talk about this in the show. Come into the show, and we'll be bantering about it. Like, okay. We've been.
Well, I was gonna say, let's do this. Oh, I have the hat dance song queued up. Uh-huh. Let's come back with a song. You basically do a quick thing about, just do a quick plug for us on the Follow the Dad Bro Show Instagram, Twitter at Dad Bro Show, but in Spanish.
Okay.
And then we'll say, hey, welcome back to the Cinco De Mayo show with Alvaro the Engineero. And then we can talk about the stuff. All right, ready? We're going to record.
Bienvenidos, gracias por entonar en la nueva radio de Dad Bros Show. Por favor, síganos en Twitter, Instagram y Facebook. Ahí nos vemos. You like that?
Yeah, okay. Not too bad.
Works out. I like it.
You almost sound like you know what you're doing.
Yeah, details.
Hopefully we'll get some more subscribers now that they understand what we're saying.
Yeah.
I mean, don't know how to subscribe, but
we're on the Twitter, the Facebook, and the Instagram.
Yeah. Too bad this is just a podcast. We could totally do closed captioning.
Yeah,
you know what? You know what would be funny if I started doing SAP.
Yeah, yeah, that'd be a little confusing, though. I think that's something in post we'd have to do.
Yeah.
You could do voiceover work.
I'd have to get two of my cousins to come out and do voiceovers for John and Josh.
This just becomes a whole different show then.
Hey, man, it's all about content.
So so have you been following us? Do you follow us on the Twitter or Instagram?
Yeah, man. Got to.
You have any advice for us? Any tips?
No, you know. Really,
Tweet more?
Tweet more or, you know, Instagram it?
Instagram... You know, it seems to be a more fun way to go right now. Twitter, I don't know what to do with it. Because Twitter, we have more followers on Instagram than Twitter.
Yeah, I could see that.
And it seems like hashtags and things work much better on Instagram than Twitter right now.
Well, it feeds to everything, Twitter and Facebook.
Yeah.
But, I mean, we were having this conversation earlier how Twitter's, you know, they took a huge tank here lately, so.
Yeah. So it makes me wonder what social media is going to stick around, because
the
go ahead
funny part Excited. College students right now is Snapchat.
Yeah, I was going to say I did an informal poll. I teach teens Brazilian jiu-jitsu, and I did a little poll with them, and I said, "What are you guys on?" Because none of you are on Facebook.
I didn't know where they was.
No.
I didn't know where that's going. What are you got, crack?
No. A friend of mine does comic books, and he's trying to reach a young audience. And he's, what are they on? So I figured I'd just kind of ask these guys what they're doing. Most of them were on Instagram, and then the rest were on Snapchat.
Yeah, I don't understand Snapchat.
See, that's why they're on it.
This is
they're on it because we don't get it.
That was my exact same response to it.
Other than what we use it for,
sending Ted penis pictures back and forth.
Ted Bison and old Chris Kiesling, he's the one that turned us to Snapchat.
So you do use Snapchat?
I do.
I'm not even on it. I don't even.
John hasn't,
Do we have to
subscribe?
Do we need to get on there then?
I think we should.
Are we missing out on some good stuff?
Yeah, Nick is on it.
What?
Ted Bison's on it.
What?
Chris is on it.
Unbelievable.
Alicia's on it. Katie's on it.
Another one to keep up with?
Yeah. So what do we drop then?
I don't know.
Twitter.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't use Twitter before the show, so I don't even.
Twitter,
I still don't even understand how.
To me, Twitter is more about fake. I don't know. Twitter doesn't seem real anymore.
It's not real, but
the people on Twitter, it seems like none of them are being. Honest about what they're doing.
What I don't like at Twitter is because you only have, 158 characters?
But 40. That's what I liked about it. When I used to do Twitter pretty strong a few years ago, and what I liked about it was it made me edit what I was saying to make everything very concise. It was almost like a form of it was almost like an art where you have an idea, and then you start eliminating and go, how can I convey this in 140 characters? Like a haiku.
Well, you were being... Yeah, you were trying to keep stuff to 140 characters. There's people out there who will go tweet.
I don't like that.
And it's like,
I don't want to follow.
Really? Why don't you just blog?
Part one of two or part one of seven.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna do that. Yeah, Patton Oswalt's bad about that.
Glenn Beck does it too, and it's kind of annoying sometimes.
It should be. Here's a tweet. If you're interested in more, go to this website.
Do like a Bitly.
Yeah.
Tiny
URL or something.
These social media sites, their main thing is the advertising. Do you even notice the advertising on
these absolutely, things? Man. Especially like the latest Twitter update, the amount of ads.
Yeah. No, let me rephrase that. Do you pay attention?
Does the advertising do anything? Is it effective?
Every time you click on one of those, all they hear on the other side is cha-ching.
Yeah, but who's clicking on it?
Yeah, that's the thing. Because basically, I have gotten to the point where I've tuned out all the advertising.
Yeah.
The only ones that I can't ignore are when you go to a website and then something pops up that you have to close.
Yeah.
And to me, the only thing to be... I thought about this like a visual, thing where someone's trying to read a book and someone keeps slapping an advertisement sticker on every page. You gotta peel it off before you can read what you wanted to read. But
that's awesome.
I think that we're close to that not being the model anymore because nobody's paying attention to the advertising, which sucks for...
The other thing I don't like about Twitter is there's a lot of, porn stuff, popping up lately.
You don't like that?
Well,
that's a complaint?
Huh. I don't know what you're talking about.
I was going to complain that the reason I don't use Twitter is there's not enough porn stuff on there. I have to read other people's stuff before...
But it's spam.
It's interfering with my porn.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's stuff like I don't subscribe to.
Who are you following?
The real reason I have
Vivid videos.
Yeah.
It's like the only reason I follow is because of NASCAR. It's
that. I mean, just for the stories.
Was that your excuse?
Yeah, just for the stories.
Just for the stories.
I follow NASCAR. That's why.
Nice. But it's like, it's like unsolicited stuff that annoys me the most. It's like the retweets and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That's just annoying to me.
I don't get, I got Twitter, but since I left and came back, I don't understand it anymore.
I'm not excited anymore.
Oh, that's not porn.
No, not that. I'm talking about that.
Oh.
You know?
No, I'm talking about that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
It's like, Seriously.
Well, everything is that way now. It seems to be like that's like the... to have some tantalizing or titillating... titillating.
Titillizing?
Titillizing headline or some kind of thing that grabs you. Grabs you by the grabbers.
And, right in the grab area.
In the grab basket. Oh, yeah, but even then, that's not...
Well, you this know one, this you, one's you, act, you
then
know.
Unsubscribe from that guy.
I have.
Or tweet him. Hey, jackhole, stop tweeting
report
stuff
him.
Out.
Report him.
That's the other thing that I hate about Twitter. It's not very well policed.
Mm.
Well,
that's good, though.
You know, like Instagram, you report them, and they're gone.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, with spam and stuff?
Yeah.
You know, what I like about Twitter is that it allows you to be at least known. Like, if you had a complaint about somebody, a business or something.
Oh, I recently did that. Yeah. I did it to Lowe's. The Lowe's, I hate talking about them, but I dislike Lowe's.
Lowe's Home Improvement Store, right?
Yes. Okay. Wow. I totally miss having Home
Because they always
Depot.
Try to kick you off their property when you're standing out there for too long.
That was Home Depot. Let's get it right.
Okay.
That's why I miss Home Depot.
Yeah.
We ordered a vanity from Lowe's. They said it'll be here in 3 days.
Yeah.
It was Tuesday.
Tres días. I gotcha.
We didn't get it until like the seventh day. And the only reason we even got it is because we bought it twice at a different Lowe's across town.
Oh.
And so I got smart. You know, I tweeted Lowe's. I was like, well, you know. I forgot what it was, but anyways, it was bannering, and you know, and they actually responded.
Yeah,
which was nice to know that they're actually looking at their feeds and stuff. But they didn't do anything to make it better.
Yeah, well,
so say if Twitter was leaving, once Twitter's gone, where's that connection between consumer or person and entity that normally wouldn't be able to be talked to, like. That is the void that Twitter fills.
Yeah,
is that you can talk directly to those.
I don't know. I wish yesterday was my cheat day for my food, and I went to Hardee's and got a Mile High bacon biscuit.
Nice. How was that?
Very disappointing because I drove away and you know leave the drive through and I get my sandwich.
Was it not a Mile
out.
High?
There was probably more bacon on the regular bacon egg and cheese biscuit than was on this biscuit.
Oh, yeah, I thought
it was
you were
just
gonna
it
say
was,
there was more.
They
bacon
basically
on
just
this
chopped
one.
It up and it was crumbly. That was the only difference. And I wish I'd taken a picture and tweeted and all that, but it was one of those where I didn't have time to. But it probably wouldn't have made a difference. But
you didn't go back and throw it into the window and
I wanted to.
Yeah.
You know when you order something and you get it and it's not right.
Yeah.
You can't. There's nothing you can do about it because you're time constrained. Like the reason I went to the drive-through is because I don't have time. And now to make this right, I had to turn around. Like there have been times where I've done that and I've been so disgusted that I can't eat the thing that they gave me because they didn't listen and it was you know, I've done that.
I had an incident where. That was almost the same thing. It was like a bagel shop, and I got a Western bagel. So it was like peppers and onions. I think it's got bacon, egg, some cheese on a bagel. Well, they left the egg off, like the meatiest chunk of the bagel. And I was leaving town. I was like, I had a trailer hooked up, and I'm leaving town, and I had swung in here and grabbed it. It was a pain, that, you know. And I'm like, all right, well, I'm not gonna open this thing up and eat it until I get on the long straightaway, get on the interstate. And I opened it up, and I was like, what the goddamn thing? And I was so furious that I actually called the store.
What'd you do?
I did. I called the store.
Dear
and I was like,
Mr. Store owner,
I'm like,
I'm a white male.
I'm like,
and I'm so freaking pissed.
I called the store, and I'm like, look, you know, I was just in there, and I ordered one of your Western bagels. And I get it. I'm on the road. I get there, and I'm like, there's no egg in it. And she's like, oh, I'm really sorry. Yeah, I was wondering why that egg was still sitting in the steamer. Like she knew like there was an egg in the steamer and nobody had ordered a thing. I'm like, yeah, well, that was my egg. And so, you know, the manager or whatever is on the phone and she's like, well, she's like, can you come back? We'll make it right. No. I'm like 20 minutes down the road.
So why are you calling then? What do you want us to do?
Well, that's what I felt like. It's like it shouldn't have been that. And then so she's like, well, look. My name is this. Just next time you're in, you know, ask for me. Tell me tell me that we talked on the phone and that you had this issue, and what I'll do is I'll take care of you. I'll get you set up with a new, you know, free of charge, all this stuff. And I'm like, that's even too much work. Like, yeah. And then that's the point. I was mad enough to call. Yeah. I was mad enough to kind of, I didn't yell because I hate yelling at people for stuff. And I was like, I explained what happened, but then after that, yeah, I kind of realized, like, why did I even call? Like, right. What's going to come of this? You know, now I have to go in and look for this person, tell them about the thing,
yeah.
And then it becomes this big process just so I can get an egg on my bagel. Like, it's not worth it.
I don't know why we get so mad about that, because there have been times where there was one time where I went through again with Hardee's. They had
Hardee's.
Yeah.
Why do you keep going back?
I don't know. I figure, like, all right, you know what? They've had enough time. Maybe they've gotten it together. They seem very popular, and the food, I like them. I like their biscuits. I like, you know. But they had I think it was a ribeye steak, egg, and cheese biscuit.
Yeah.
And I said, oh, man, I want one of those. So I go to the drive-thru. Yes, I'd like one of those steak, egg, and cheese biscuits, please. And I pull up, you know, go through the whole thing. She gives me the thing. I open it. It's a fried steak plus egg plus cheese. Like, that's how they have to put it in. You know, country fried steak, add egg, add cheese.
Yeah.
It's like, no, why would you give me that? You right outside, you have this big advertisement
for three separate biscuits?
No, it was not three separate biscuits. It was one biscuit. Like, why would I go steak, egg, and cheese biscuit?
Like, instead of getting the ribeye steak, he got the country fried steak always have.
Yeah.
Added steak and added cheese to it.
But even though he's like, looking at right like a 12-foot poster. Window, and then you go, and I'm like, oh, you didn't say that.
You didn't say ribeye.
You know what? You could have said, which one do you want? If there was, because why? I didn't say edge. It was like such a confusing thing. Well, I can go ahead. I can remake it if you want. I was just like so angry. I just balled it up and drove up to the trash can. It's right next to the thing there and just chucked it in there and drove away. And then I regret it because like, I left hungry.
Emotions.
Yeah. It was like this, like the stupid interaction that I let get to me.
I wish they really had instant replay when you order.
Yeah,
you know that's all fine and well, but you know those screens they put on in the drive-thrus. Doesn't it irritate you even though you're telling them it's wrong, and you have a screen to verify that it's wrong? They still get it wrong.
Yeah, and or when it takes so long for that screen to update. So you're telling you to
pull around
and you're waiting.
Yeah,
I'm waiting for the screen. You can't pull around yet.
That's the purpose of the screen.
Well, yeah. Here's the thing that what bothered me so much about it too is that I've been very strict on my diet because I got to get ready for summer. Okay, I have one day a week where I can eat what I want, and they screwed it up. And what's even more disappointing. Is I've learned that I don't need to do that because the end thing now apparently is something called dad bod. Do you know what dad bod is?
Dad bod.
What is dad bod?
Dad bod is just like a regular dude.
Hold on. What is dad bod?
Well, let's listen to some of the description then, because dad bod is apparently the new rage as far as how we look.
Dad bod.
And, yeah, dad bod. Blew my mind. All this effort.
You threw it to me, but I wasn't ready for it. Here we go.
I'm trying to just draw it out.
One of these channels.
And we're talking about dad bods today. These are guys who look like they go to the gym, but they also maybe enjoy the finer things in life, a little pizza, a little beer. The look is trending really big right now, and Jesse will explain more on the dad bod phenomenon.
That's right, Larry. It's true.
A phenomenon.
A phenomenon.
It's a phenomenon.
Of a guy who looks like he likes to drink a little beer and eat pizza.
Well, yeah. Isn't that...
That's every normal? Guy.
I'm part of a phenomenon.
I thought that
guys.
Was like normal.
Yeah.
I gotta Google this.
Well, let's hear him out. This is not something we may not want to fight with this.
Now, and Jesse will explain more on the dad bod phenomenon.
That's right, Larry. It's true. You can call it an early Father's Day gift. Undefined abs and maybe even a little bit of flab are actually in. GQ has even coined it the dawn of the dad bod. And these things are everywhere. We even found a couple dad bods
these
right
things?
Here in Times Square.
These things are, is that the dad bod is a thing?
He did say undefined abs, didn't he?
Yeah.
These things
so
are everywhere.
Shape.
Yes. Awesome. Yes. Well, some of the examples that, I think they're going to give, you can, the photos that went along with them were, well, go ahead.
Here in Times Square, guys, take a look. Are you kidding me?
So they had guys in studio there, and they're like
just regular guys. They weren't. They were just like in regular clothes.
I kind of wish we had the video.
Well, you can find it on YouTube if you want, but it was the weirdest thing to have just regular dudes standing there.
Yeah.
Hey guys, well, it's like a big joke.
You should put a link on the Instagram.
We'll link it out of here after the show. We'll put a link up.
Forget about washboard abs.
It's like you're Photoshopped.
And bulging biceps. Apparently, what women really want
is...
Wait for it.
Dad bod?
My friends and I saw this body type on a lot more guys, and we were attracted to it.
Mackenzie Pearson is a student at Clemson University.
All right, so she's a student at Clemson University, and she's attracted to my body. What else do we need to know here, folks?
I just went to Google Images.
What's her Facebook page? How can I get a hold of her?
It just looks like a bunch of college students.
Doesn't it?
Clemson University. Who's our...
Sorry. That's what it is. Go ahead. No, just go for the audio.
We'll go back to listen to her. Tell us she's...
Is a dad bod?
My friends and I saw this body type on a lot more guys, and we were attracted to it.
Mackenzie Pearson is a student at Clemson University.
So maybe she's part of a sorority, and this is like their hazing.
Yeah.
They're like, their sorority, yeah. Like their sorority joke is like, you have to go out and say that you like dad bods.
Yeah. That's
like
the only
what
thing.
Kind of cruel like, joke is that?
Is this like part of a list to be like?
Yeah, like I guess fraternities, you know how they have like all the silly things they have to do to get into the fraternity? Like maybe this is the sorority version of that.
Nice.
I don't know. Let's see.
Whose article, Why Girls Love the Dad Bod, is going wildly viral this morning. So what is a dad bod?
The dad bod is a healthy medium between someone who's a little bit heavier set and someone who works out.
Think celebs like Vince Vaughn, Will Ferrell.
We're going streaking!
Because when I think those guys, I think, man, look at those bodies.
Right!
And if you're saying somewhere between working out and basically letting yourself go, I don't think Vince Vaughn and Will Ferrell.
Who do you think of?
I would say, like an off-season. I don't know.
Arnold.
Huh? Like I mean, I don't know. Arnold's a little old to be, but like you have defined shoulders. Your arms look pretty good. Just through the middle, you're just packing on a little extra weight.
Yeah,
Adam Sandler.
Adam Sandler, Vince Vaughn, and Will Ferrell. Their arms, to me, are kind of just scrawny, skinny arms. Yeah. So like.
Definitely not the wrong.
Not a power lifter per se, but that kind of like they look strong.
Like
but
a
at the same
like a
time.
Vin Diesel in the off season when he's not filming a movie,
right.
Or like
in the off season,
when he's not filming, or The Rock when he's not filming, they carry a little extra weight,
right?
I mean, they don't have guts and everything, but I don't know. Let's see.
And the internet's apparent favorite dad bod to behold, Jason Segel's.
I don't know who that is. Surprise.
Okay, so Jason Segel, we're going to have to bring this up. Josh
who's
doesn't
Jason
know who
Jason Segel.
Jason Segel is the guy he's on, what's that, How I Met Your Mother, and he's on the Forgetting Sarah Marshall. Do you remember that movie?
Mm-mm.
You don't remember that? Let me bring him up.
You might have to go with the flavor.
Because I've actually been told, I had a girl tell me that I look like this guy.
Oh. So that's how you know him.
What about Seinfeld?
I know him because of mostly because of Forgetting Sarah Marshall. I thought it was a decent movie, and he wrote and directed all that crap. But he's
Will Smith.
He's
is a
this
good
guy.
Dad bod,
you see him? Like he's Will Smith is in shape.
That's what I'm saying. He's in shape, but he's not like ripped.
So this guy, does he look familiar? Like
no.
All right, you got to see him in his.
I don't have no. I don't. He doesn't look familiar.
He's what else has he done?
Let me see what else he's done.
You'll run through his entire IMDb, and I'll have not seen any of them.
Forgetting Sarah Marshall.
Nope.
Nope. Okay.
Muppet movie. Nope.
He was in the Muppet movie. You didn't watch the Muppet movie.
No.
He was a main character in the Muppet movie.
Didn't see Knocked Up. Didn't see Dead Man on Campus.
Who's dead?
All right, I tell you what I'll do. This will be better. Just an image search real quick. Jason Segel. I guess it's spelled like that. I don't know. Full frontal. There we go.
Wow. I don't want to see this already.
Go. You can't. I mean, like, the dude, he's been on a ton of stuff.
None of it I've seen.
This guy, you know who I'm talking about, no, right? Like, that right there, that's
yeah,
classic,
I know who you're talking
that's
about
classic Siegel.
See, yeah, but he looks to me picture, like
he's very average looking. What does that say about me? That's not good.
He looks like Mac. He
he's
looks
a
like,
very handsome guy.
He looks
Josh.
Like he's Michael Rapaport's brother.
I don't know. I want
maybe
to look
he
like
is,
this guy.
I don't know. Yeah, that's nice. So, okay, so this, but so he is known.
That's dead bro right there,
so
right?
He is known for his, like, he doesn't have like he, and again, I don't even think he works out.
Why are you searching frontal?
Because I was going to say, like, because you can see
the
body.
Yeah, but that's the thing. That's the thing. That's what
like,
they're.
This,
that's what they're getting.
Like
at.
His body's not. Yeah. Yeah.
So this is the this is the hot thing now. So I've been.
You know what I think about?
I've been strict on my diet and working very hard at leaning.
And
our
wives have been
this.
Lying to us the whole
yeah.
time.
Yeah.
What they really want is a dad bod.
You don't want Chris Hemsworth. You want this.
Yeah.
No wonder you've been. No,
actually,
no.
Josh, it's even better than that. You see, our wives want Chris Hemsworth. They want abs and they want that.
That's true.
College girls, Josh. College girls want dad bods. So this pot keeps getting sweeter and sweeter.
Yeah.
All right. All right. I'm liking it. All right, let's get back to see what else it says.
Well, you, according to Pearson's not-so-scientific observations, even young college guys are embracing the dad bod phenomenon.
You try to maintain that healthy body, but at the same time, I like to have fun and go out and drink on the weekends.
You're
Pearson
absolutely
attributes
right.
The hypnotic nature of the dad bod to a few factors.
The college girls, absolutely right.
The hypnotic nature of the dad bod.
Now, not only do you get the dad bod,
this might,
but you get the whole dad background.
This might would be a circumstance where we would actually need a wife's opinion on what is the hypnotic nature.
But the
nature.
Thing is, the
how
wife wouldn't know.
Dad bod hip-
the wife wouldn't know.
So
they're
we need
out
the
of
college
it.
Girls
you,
in here.
We need college girls.
So we might have to come back to the story with some college girls in
right.
the studio.
And get some opinions.
I mean, well, if it's for the show, Josh,
yeah.
we have to do it.
And we'll have to basically show what we've got and see what's, you know, where are we on the dad bod scale. And
that's
how,
true.
Yeah.
Yeah. And how does it hypnotize you?
Yeah.
And what does it make you feel like?
Are you hypnotized?
You yes. can hit it on Instagram.
Yeah.
Before mm-hmm. after pictures.
Yeah. For one, she says dad bods aren't as intimidating.
It makes girls, I think, feel a lot more vulnerable when they aren't with someone who's, you know, meal prepping every Sunday and being really intimidating.
Now, what girl have you ever heard that's looking at a chiseled body guy go, he's really intimidating and he meal preps every day? And or do they just say, like, oh my God, look at that? Like, I mean.
Well, here's the thing.
Please explain meal prep.
We don't see what this college girl looks like.
Oh,
so
Josh, you got
she
a point
might be
there.
The kind that's intimidated
oh,
by some
boy.
Doing that.
Oh,
see, we're not. This
boy.
Is not necessarily one of those Jersey Shore girls.
Meal prepping is basically you're creating like your entire breakfast, lunch, dinner in between, you know, a little bit of brown rice, chicken.
Yeah.
You're pre-planning.
So you're pre-planning your meals
yeah,
for the week.
So that you don't eat.
I thought this was like. This
yeah,
gym thing.
Yeah, it's just it's bro science stuff. Sticking strict to a diet.
Yeah,
so.
planning your day out food wise.
Says that dad bods are comfy and people actually like cuddling with someone who's a little bit softer. So my question is, guys, who's got pizza?
Are you liking the dad bod phenom?
Yeah, you know, I think it's fun. I think, you know, guys kind of own it. They make fun of it themselves. How do you guys feel about having a dad bod?
Proud.
College girls like it.
Whoa, yeah. All of a sudden, I feel a lot better about it. Yeah.
So, we in America already being described as overweight.
Yeah, so basically what it is so many people are obese. As long as you're not morbidly obese,
you're okay.
You're all right. You're doing well.
I like it.
Interesting.
You are in the dad bod
90th percentile.
We got to come out with a dad bod workout.
Oh, I like it. Dad bod workout.
Dad
yeah.
bod workout. You know, once, twice a week you do this.
Yeah.
Then
16-ounce curls.
Yeah. Drink what kind of beer you should drink. What you know, the beer timing. You know, you don't want to like been drinking's not going to get you there. You need like
you got to spread it out.
Yeah, you want to drink
like in the evenings.
Yeah, have a few beers. That leads to maybe eating too many cookies because by the time
you've
had
eat
the fourth
something.
Beer, you don't care and you're hungry and all you've got is Girl Scout cookies.
Yep.
Cookies. Yeah.
You got to eat some meal that was easy.
I know you're guilty for it.
No, it's never guilty. Happened to me. I've never done that. I've never okay. eaten so many cookies I've thrown up afterward. It's never happened now. I've never, ever. Why would you even think that?
You're trying to get that dad bro.
Have a sleeve of thanks a lot. Yeah, no, I've never done that.
You guys should come up with a dad bro body.
Dad bro. Might have to do that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, your diet consists of things that are easy for your wife to make. Yeah. So we just have that.
Wow.
Cereal and Lunchables.
Cereal and Lunchables.
Hot Pockets.
Hot Pockets. We don't have Hot Pockets. But...
Tacos.
All right. We'll leave it there.
All right, you guys.
It takes years to get
there. It takes years of hard work.
Currently, that's it, Josh. You cut off right there. So.
Well, that was the end of the story. That was the end of the YouTube clip.
So I'd like, who came I would up like with to this?
Think, well, with what?
With the whole...
Dad bod thing?
Yeah.
I don't know. I swear it's a joke. And what's funny is, well, there's a couple of things that I think are funny about it. One, you'll never see guys go the other way with it. We're really into the mom bod look, you know.
I'm really into the college girls that like dad bod look. That's the one I'm into.
You won't see a young college guy go for that unless he's smart. If he's smart, he'll go for that.
Even college guys are into dad bods.
Funny. I mean, I just got done doing a thing at a college camp, like a college living mm-hmm. area, and. I mean, I was 30 years old around a bunch of college students. So I was like, God, I want to get out of here.
Yeah.
And it's like, there's stuff that can't be unseen.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? It's like, hold on. You know, society wants us to be super skinny, super fit. And that's not what you see around here.
I don't think that's what society wants. I think, well, not society in general, but like, I think there's a divide of what we want to be and what we are.
True.
And the, like I was going to say, this whole dad bod thing, maybe it's true, but let's be honest. I mean, it's not exactly the reason guys want to look like, a big strong guy is necessarily just because of the women. Guys want to look like that way for other guys too. Like you want to be, you want to walk into the room and be the visual.
Like, hey guys,
you want to be the visual alpha in the room.
Be the bear in the room.
That guy's a strong guy. Don't mess with him.
That guy's a bear.
That guy will. He looks tough.
That guy will grab you.
Yeah.
Hold you tight.
He'll hold you down and make you do what he wants.
Wow.
But no, it's not just it's a competition thing. It's got nothing to do with you want to be,
alpha male.
Yeah, you want to be alpha male. When you came in here and started messing with the board there, Engineero, you alphaed us off of the board.
Yeah,
it's just my job. Yeah,
I know, and then that's how you make it extra alpha is you act like it's no big deal.
Engineero,
it's no problem. This almost feels like, it's meant to have been a, black and white show. You know what I mean?
That's the idea.
You know what I mean? It's like, what's the name of that? The first colored Western that ever.
What is that supposed
Panda
to mean?
Rosa.
Yeah.
Oh.
It was like, it should have been like a Panda Rosa. By the way, there was no color people in that. Anyways.
Oh, okay.
There was Mexicans in it.
See, but that doesn't count?
I don't know if it does or not.
We're not allowed to say that.
You don't count
stuff.
Yourself as a POC?
What, is it too racist or something?
Not for us.
Okay.
You don't count yourself as a POC?
Appreciate it.
Are you?
I don't know. Oh. I'm born and raised in the United States. So.
Yeah, but I think you're on the spectrum of color.
Well,
as long as you're not... Yesterday
that I'm the whitest Mexican some of the people I've ever seen.
I know.
So,
I think
it depends on when it favors him.
When I went to high school, I knew a redheaded Mexican. So you're not the whitest.
Was he redheaded Mexican?
Redhead, curly red hair and freckles. Mexican. Yep.
Yeah.
You sure there was nothing wrong with him?
Nope.
Oh, Louis C.K.'s Mexican.
Louis C.K.'s Mexican too.
And he's redheaded.
Who's that?
Oh what? Boy.
He's a comedian. He's got a great show.
Hold on.
How do you not know Louis C.K.? You got to know Louis C.K.
Yeah.
I don't know. See, I'm bad with names.
Well, apparently you have your native Mexicans, and then you have your European Mexicans.
Well, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I didn't know he was Mexican.
Yeah, his first language was Spanish.
Get out.
No.
I didn't know he was Mexican.
Yeah.
It's the first... Where have I been?
Part of your people, man. He's super successful now.
Where have I been? Did he change his name or something?
No. Oh.
Like,
CK is like, that's his real name.
Yeah.
But
Carlos,
yeah, but no, but he changed it to the C dot K because that's how people could pronounce it.
Yeah, it's like me going by Al, pretty much.
Yeah.
So,
that sounded pretty cool.
Yeah. So maybe what gives the dad bod the appeal is the lack of testosterone.
Mm. Lack of testosterone. Ooh. So does it seem more approachable?
Maybe that's what. Maybe it's the softening you up, and you seem like you're less competitive and all
they
that.
And they say, "Wow, he looks ready to be whipped and told what to do."
Yeah,
He looks ready to
that's
come
probably,
to.
That's probably what it is. He looks like he'd be browbeaten into doing anything.
He looks like he can come to my house and get some stuff done. He looks like he can finish a list of projects at my house quickly.
If I tell him, if I nag him enough.
Yeah.
If I preface it with, if you want to, even though
it
doesn't mean, yeah.
Doesn't that irritate you guys?
Yes.
That if you want
yes,
to.
Yes, it does.
Gosh. I don't know.
I think that's what he was implying.
See, I mean, wow.
Yeah.
We just moved into a new house, and it's like everything comes up with, if you want to or can you?
Yeah.
It's like. Yes, I can, but...
Okay, the answer to that question is I never want to.
Yeah.
Ever.
I can do it, but I don't want to.
Yeah.
Mm. How does that work out for y'all?
What do you mean? It does. I wind up doing it anyway.
Exactly.
But basically, it's like I could... Well, here's the thing. It's like I know... You know how it's going to end. You're going to be doing it anyway. But now you get the benefit of doing it while she's angry at you. And you're doing it begrudgingly. Because you're a son of a bitch. My thing is like I don't want to do it, and then I know I'm gonna get. Well, why didn't you do it like this? Well, if you knew how to do it, why didn't you do it? Why do I have to do it if you've got all the ideas? Mm. You know, don't make me hang the shelf up and then hover over me and tell me how I should do it as I'm doing it. You don't want to say anything. Do you?
We're just letting him dig his own hole right now.
I know.
Yeah. We'll let Josh
but you're laughing. You're laughing because you've been there.
Oh, I've been there.
Yeah. But you will say, well, then say
and
something. That's the problem. That's the problem is you're going to leave me by myself and get in trouble. Nothing's going to get done because it's like, well, you're the only one with that problem. I don't understand. If we stick together, we can get some.
Never going to get
I don't know. I mean, it's like, you know, sometimes it's just like.
Thank you, RC.
Is it worth it? You know?
Yeah.
You know, is it worth? Is what worth it?
The fight.
The whole thing?
Yeah. No, it's not worth
go
it.
Go back and tell high school Alvaro. Is it worth it, dude? You should totally go for it.
Yeah.
Definitely interesting.
Think of the sweet Impala you could be driving right now. The chain steering wheel.
It would be pretty sweet.
With your PlayStation hooked up in it.
I'd be looking like George Lopez going down the road.
Georgia Lopez? Who's that?
George Lopez.
Georgia Lopez. Will you be a wig?
Nice.
So yeah.
Well, to the testosterone, I guess you found this article about dads. I guess a study shows that dads' testosterone start to drop off.
Yeah. As soon as you become a daddy.
Well, it's saying even during the pregnancy.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And then it shows when the first time you hold that baby that your testosterone level actually drops.
Are you sure?
This is what the study says.
I'm not
a scientist. Now, I'm just reporting to you the news of the day.
There are some,
as a professional dad.
I don't know about you guys, but my first child didn't. I mean, I don't think I had any kind of drop.
Well, there's some scientific reasons that there might be. If you just go down a little bit.
Now are they one doctors?
Of, well, no, like packing on pounds, you know, you put on some weight, your fat tends to store hormones, excess hormones. So, you know, as you gain weight,
as you get that dad bod,
you get the dad bod, it kind of holds onto some of the testosterone or not getting enough sleep. That could hold your
that doesn't
testosterone
happen
back.
As a dad.
No, nah, yeah. Get out.
You
know.
Sleep all the time. Your wife's the one doing all the work.
Yeah.
You know, 1 o'clock, you know, throw up.
They're never. I don't know what you're talking about. That never happened in my house.
I see what he's trying to do right now.
Excessive stress. Infants are adorable and cuddly. Stress.
But when you have kids, I mean, you normally have like, it's pretty stressful. I mean,
well, that's what it's saying is that all the extra stress that you have, and all these things combined together drive your testosterone levels down, and then. I don't know, when your testosterone levels go down, you also have estrogen as well.
Yeah.
So you turn into a big fat.
But it's one of the things it's saying, one of the things they're trying to make this say is that it's there's a biological reason. Like when your testosterone drops, you don't have that wandery eye. And you know, it would keep you from straying. It'll keep you from straying. It's like, I don't know.
Are you alive?
Okay, let's clear this up real quick, because that's something I think is a fallacy, I guess. Monogamy is a choice. And for a guy, it is a constant physical battle as a choice.
I'm glad you're getting to this one and not me.
And it's not. I'm not saying that it's a it's a struggle. But it's not something that is a...
But why is it a struggle?
It's not a direct struggle. Because you're constantly... You're like a lion, okay? You're a lion. You like eating zebras.
Then that is totally discredits...
Well, let me finish my point if you want to argue it. This is the debate.
I'm not arguing.
I'm a lion, right? And I love eating zebras, okay? And I have a zebra at home.
Don't you have a lioness?
I'll spin this a different way after this one, so then maybe we'll...
But I go out and about... And there are zebras, and they're the nicest zebras with the greatest stripes out there. And you just want to eat a zebra.
Yeah, but what about the lion?
How about this? How about this?
I'm so confused.
All right, let's say this. Let's say you're a hungry gentleman, and you have a restaurant. You have a restaurant that you enjoy very much, right?
Taqueria.
And this taqueria says, you know what, Al? What we're gonna do is sign a contract, and you can only eat at this restaurant, but you can eat here, you know, whenever. Okay, cool. You sign that contract, and then 6 months later, you show up to eat at the restaurant. Oh yeah, we're not serving food right now. You can talk to the hostess all you want. Maybe you can go back and sweep up if you want. You know, all that stuff. But you can't eat here. And then across the street, there's another taqueria that's opened up.
A brand new one.
And then there's a Bojangles that's opened up right next to that. You're like, oh.
You smell the smell wafting.
But you signed a contract now. You can't eat any of those places. Now, your restaurant's not serving any food right now, but you're hungry still, and you want to go look at those restaurants. What do you do?
I don't know.
Isn't it tough? You're sitting there with your face pressed up against the glass, looking across the street at all the wonderful.
But there's
a Jimmy John's over
better.
There. If it's better, yeah, it's better. But what good is it when the kitchen's not open?
True story.
The chef's not here today.
But see, this is the.
You can go make your own food. You want to go make your own food? You can go to the bathroom and make your own food if you want.
Well, just to say, I mean, the testosterone thing then here is ridiculous because. Isn't that what really drives you?
Well, that's what it's saying. Is it saying that because men have lower testosterone, the testosterone drops, is that they're less likely to stray because they don't have that drive to want to, if we break it down to simplest levels, you don't have that drive to want to procreate.
But
what I'm saying is that it is a mental challenge. You mentally have to, for monogamy to work and for you to not to be chased, it's a mental challenge that you actually have to mentally say, I can't do it.
Yeah. The physical part of it is I just need that release where you need to get fed.
You need to procreate. That's what it meant. A guy's drive, a guy's down to the bottom, like bare bone primal instinct is I need to procreate and I need to do as much as possible.
Testosterone.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
I mean, but
it doesn't care where you go.
No.
But testosterone doesn't care where you go.
It's not a hormonal level that decides that where you go or what. Who it's with. That's all mental.
Yeah.
That's the difference.
Part is whatever's available to you. So if you've got it coming at you all the time, that's going to be tough. But if you're not going to be out prowling for it, but if it comes at you, then
you want to redo this ever again?
What?
Honestly?
Katie and I
am not looking for another wife ever again. Something happens.
See, that's exactly.
Done.
Yeah. I mean, I think we're all in the same
boat.
Every guy I've ever talked to, that's, yeah.
I mean, Why?
And that's what keeps you from straying, because you know exactly what road it goes down and where it leads.
It goes to Lonely Town.
And you're right back where
you
are.
But then it doesn't seem sad.
The grass is the same color on either side.
I mean, really? I mean, why would he want to do it again?
I don't know.
It's like...
You can't think of another reason?
I mean, my wife is clear as that. Not again. Ever again.
Yeah.
I mean...
I don't know about you guys, but I think I did the best the first time around. There's no way of topping it.
Yeah.
Oh, his testosterone level just dropped over there.
You're going to need to get the other one out.
I heard the whip across the hallway over there.
One of my interesting... this article here, something I thought that was interesting when I was reading through it, after you sent it to me there, is that with moms, it's pretty clear about... pregnancies and how hormonal levels will fluctuate and the differences that it can make. Sorry, folks, you're hearing a sound. I'm opening a second bottle of tequila in here, drinking the show. This is the same brand, but this one is a flavored tequila. I believe almond flavor. So we're going to sip of that as well.
So you were saying.
But I was saying it was interesting that in the article that, like, clearly we know, you know, it's been proven, we know that women's hormone levels fluctuate, which is what, you know, postpartum depression.
Constantly. It constantly fluctuates.
Yeah, they say it's just during pregnancy, but I'm pretty sure it's mostly after marriage. But, you know, but it's been documented, we know that. But the thing that, you know, I guess this is a study that's relatively new, and the guy's hormone levels fluctuating, and namely testosterone, which is the biggest thing that drives the difference between men and women.
What makes a man a man?
What makes a man a man? So,
wow. You smell that?
I don't. What are we talking about? We were talking about what makes a man a man.
Oh my gosh.
That?
Yeah.
Woo! So let's try this new tequila. This is the almond flavored tequila. Let's give it a quick sip.
Gosh, that smells good.
That is smooth.
It's a little too smooth. A little too sweet.
And it tastes like water at the end.
Yeah,
this could be dangerous.
Now it tastes like cough syrup.
Yeah. You were saying with the.
Well, and it was just the point that this is something that's probably overlooked because it's not something we want to think of as being associated with having kids and stuff. Is that testosterone would go down because you weren't directly involved in the kid being
right?
Like a woman's hormone level has changed because there was actually a physical bodily change that happened.
Well, I think what happened is all the reasons. Basically, I think the entire article is BS until it gets to the reasons why your testosterone dress and lack of sleep and you know that those seem like the biggest factors because those every time you ever read an article for bodybuilding or whatever,
all the time.
Yeah, whenever that happens, whenever you
look at me, Josh. Protein mom.
Look at me, Josh. All the time, I'm reading those articles.
But they want to
take shirt off, start snapping.
But if you ever read an article on how to increase your testosterone, getting enough sleep, avoiding stress, those are the top of the list.
What if you have an issue and you can't produce it, and you got it? You know, sometimes you know medically that you have to get shots because I mean, generally testosterone causes you to sleep, like. You know what I mean?
Well, testosterone gives you like energy, gives you vigor.
But it kept you from sleeping. Yeah. Not kept you from sleep, but let you recover faster, so you don't have to sleep as much.
Yeah, but I mean, do you go days without sleeping to finally get a good night's rest? You know what I mean? I mean, I don't know. I'm confused right now.
Yeah,
I know, it's like. I have a friend who has testosterone issues where his body just doesn't produce enough,
mm-hmm.
and the guy can't sleep at all.
Was he originally a guy?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just because I'm California, okay?
Oh, okay.
But as soon as he started shots, he went like right back to normal.
TRT.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, it's just a medicated TRT.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean...
Which TRT, for those of you who don't know, is testosterone replacement therapy.
Yep.
And, I mean, he went from being, like, up all night every day to having an actual good sleep. So it's like, you know,
I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know what any of it is.
You know what I know, but I don't know what you know.
I don't know where I'm going with this.
So we know.
Anyways, hormone therapy.
Engineer.
So, anyways, so ladies, let's take it a little easy on the guys, even though you're not listening to this show, because this is strictly a dad's only show. Go back to work, or not to work,
Dappers.
In the kitchen, whatever you're gonna do. Instagram.
And for the wives, this is strictly just for entertainment purposes only. We don't mean anything we've ever said on the show.
Has anything you've ever heard here?
Been, for Josh, please have his pillow.
I want to hang the shelves. And
I need all your opinions on how to do it.
Yeah, give me your ideas. I'm eager to hear suggestions.
Sorry, we're not supposed to laugh, Al. It doesn't help him out at all. So, boy, just, you know, think of this as a possibility.
Do you
that
guys
ever dig,
like,
can
bigger
drop.
Holes for yourselves?
All the time.
That's pretty much
I can't keep my
is.
Mouth shut.
Pretty much what the show is, Al.
And it's like,
it's a shovel that we dig holes with.
I well, my people know about shovels, yeah. But
oh come on, Al. Jeez.
Why is it always got to go there with you?
Hey man, because it's always there.
So, well,
it's like a gray cloud.
Do you see it coming when you do that? When you dig your hole deeper?
Well, the thing is that I say it and you go.
Then you have
why
to make
did
a
I
decision.
Say that? You know what I mean?
Well, there's times where it's right in front of you and you got to weigh the option. Do I say it now? So that way I can say I told you so, or whatever the
I don't think the I told you so works out too
it
well.
It doesn't. No, it doesn't work out well as far as
that's
as,
probably the worst.
It doesn't, but it is a it's a satisfying on the inside knowing that you were right. Basically,
and then you get the hammer.
Well, here's the thing. The I told
or
you
or
so.
She gets the hammer.
You're hoping the I told you so is a will serve later for when you say something that you know you're right on.
Never works.
And, you know, you're going to listen to me now because I've how many times have I said I told you so? And but no, it never does. And it's just a little inside moral victory for you. I'm not going to do that because I told you so.
Shout out to your mama.
Yeah.
So.
Mom's monitoring the chat room.
Speaking of testosterone, I bet that Floyd Mayweather could have used some testosterone, huh?
Lord have mercy.
Good segue, Josh.
Thank you.
I mean that I didn't feel like shelling out $100 for to watch Fight at Home, nor was I going to go pay $25 as a cover charge.
What?
Dude,
that's
they
a
were
steep price.
They were charging some places you had to have a reservation.
Really?
There was two places in Greenville that had it. It was VW3s and
Hooters.
Hooters, that's right. And Hooters was requiring reservations, and they had like a $25 cover charge.
Wow.
And I think for day of, it was more than that.
Well, at $100 $100 a pay per view for a regular person,
that's
now
ridiculous.
Businesses. For a business, it's way higher.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We went to a bar one time for a UFC, and that was at the time when a pay-per-view was $40. And the bar had to pay, what was it, $1,000 a screen?
It was probably for their seating capacity.
Yeah, so because you're a business, it's $1,000 per screen, and they had...
Or was it per tuner, like per satellite tuner?
Yeah, but basically, it was costing this bar like $10,000 to run the UFC.
Yeah.
So you figure...
How do you make money like that?
So you figure that Pacquiao fight, Mayweather fight, would have been $25,000?
Yeah, right about.
They have to charge then.
Wow. And the fight itself was ridiculous. There wasn't really... I mean, I don't understand how Mayweather... He kept running away for most of it.